Hey guys, welcome back for chapter 12 of 2 Corinthians today. The author Paul is continuing on in his final letter to the church at Corinth. It's more good stuff like always to go over and study, so let's get into it. This is the Bible Vlog. Chapter 12 opens up with Paul describing a really unique thing that apparently happened to him shortly after he came to know Christ. Now, one of the things that the Bible does teach about is visions or miraculous insight that God will sometimes provide at his discretion. So Paul speaks of an experience that he had like this, but he doesn't go into detail on what he saw or what he was told. So let's go ahead and read about it in verses 2 through 4. I know a man in Christ who 14 years ago, whether in the body I do not know, or whether out of the body I do not know, God knows, such a one was caught up to the third heaven. And I know such a man, whether in the body or out of the body, I do not know, God knows, how he was caught up into paradise and heard inexpressible words which it is not lawful for a man to utter. Now when Paul says he knows a man, he's referring to himself in third person to avoid appearing like he's bragging. Now what he's describing here is that Paul was literally brought to heaven for a moment to receive a message from God and be in his presence. Now this is an extremely unusual and rare thing to happen. Even most of Jesus' own disciples never experienced anything like this. But Paul says that while this happened, he heard words said that he is not allowed to repeat. Now, we'll actually see this same thing again in the book of Revelation. The disciple John, who wrote Revelation, also described an experience similar to this, where he had a heavenly vision and then wrote down most of what he saw. But even during his vision, he heard and saw certain things that he was not allowed to write about. Now, some of you all may be wondering what the third heaven or paradise is that he describes here, so let me explain. In many ancient cultures, the word heavens was used to describe three different realms. Those were number one, the sky, number two, what we would call outer space, and number three, an actual spiritual heaven. Now again, keep in mind that all three of these places were areas that man had not gone at this point in human history. There were no planes or rocket ships. So what Paul is saying is he went to this third and final spiritual heaven where he received a message from God. Now whether this was in a vision in his mind or Paul was physically taken up in his own body, we don't know, and even Paul himself didn't know. Finally, when Paul uses the word paradise in reference to this third heaven, this simply refers to a place of incredible fellowship with God. All right, move ahead just a little bit, and let's look at this next passage in verses 7 through 10. And lest I should be exalted above measure by the abundance of the revelations, a thorn in the flesh was given to me, a messenger of Satan to buffet me, lest I should be exalted above measure. Concerning this thing, I pleaded with the Lord 3 times that it might depart from me, and he said to me, my grace is sufficient for you, for my strength is made perfect in weakness. Therefore, most gladly, I will rather boast in my infirmities that the power of Christ may rest upon me. Now, this section of scripture has been hotly debated and argued over the years. What was this so-called thorn in the flesh? Was it some kind of addiction that Paul had? Was it a demon, some kind of disease or sickness? Why did God let it happen? Well, before we go too far down that road, we need to recognize that it's pointless to try and figure out exactly what the issue was. I mean, if it was important for us to know, then Paul would have told us. Instead, the main point that he tries to express is that he received such overwhelming wisdom and revelation from God that God used this thing as a reminder to Paul not to be self-reliant on the things that he knew. Guys, even with everything Paul knew and was given, he still had to rely on the grace and sufficiency of Christ. And if you think about it, we see this same thing play out with so many people today. They finally get an answer to their prayer, and then what do? They quit praying to God altogether. They think, why spend time with God anymore when I got what I want? I'll just coast on this until I need something else. But God doesn't want that. He wants to be your source. He wants you to seek him daily and not just when you need something. Paul is showing us here that no matter what he was given, he was constantly reminded for his need of the fellowship of God. Because when we are weak, God is always strong. All right, guys, well, that is going to do it for us yet again today with chapter 12. Man, just one more to go, and then we are going to be wrapping this one up. Well, thank you as always for joining us today. Certainly means the world that you're here. Come back tomorrow for the final chapter of the week, chapter 13, and then certainly Wednesday we'll be moving on to the next one. Hope you have a beautiful day wherever you may be watching this from. Be blessed. We will see you back here tomorrow.